Hello everyone, thank you so much for joining me here on my YouTube channel. I am here to provide insight and guidance for all air signs. Libra, Sagittarius. Libra, you could be dealing with the Sagittarius. Okay, so Libra, Gemini, and Aquarius. Okay, let me get my timer on because my fire sign reading was like 34 minutes, and it's because I lost track of time. So, all right, so I'm here to provide insight and guidance for all air signs. So this can apply, of course, to your sun, moon, or rising. If you have a midhaven that's in an air sign, it definitely could apply as well. This reading will not apply to all air signs, and that's okay. Take what resonates and leave what doesn't. You may want to take a look at the other readings to see how it may resonate, but of course you need some understanding of your birth chart and what zodiac influences are in your birth chart to better understand. Okay, so air sign, let's get started. I switched things up a bit, so I'll go ahead and do the reading for all the air signs, and then I'll pull an additional card, and then I'll take a look at your love life and see what's surrounding it and what's going on for each of you guys. Libra, Libra, Aries, oh my god, Libra, Aquarius, and Gemini. Oh my god, it was hard to get that out. Okay, so some of you air signs may be feeling like an airhead. Like I am. I have some air in my chart, so I can say that. Maybe feeling like a airhead and not able to really get the words out. It's hard to express what's on your mind, okay? Some of you may smoke too damn much. That may cause a little bit of fog, but okay. So let's get started, all right? So what's surrounding all air signs, Libra, Gemini, and Aquarius in January 2019? What's surrounding all air signs, what's surrounding all air signs in January 2019? What's surrounding all air signs in January 2019? What's surrounding all air signs? Libra, Gemini, and Aquarius. Okay, Ben, okay, so, oh Lord, so air signs, you guys have the same cards as some of the fire signs, so air sign, you could be definitely dealing with the fire sign person. So with the Three of Swords was there, but it was in right side up, and then the Ace of Wands was there, and the Five of Wands was there. All right, I gotta seat my baby boy. Anyway, there you go. Eat up. Okay. Alright. Okay, so we have the Hierophant in reverse, Three of Swords in reverse, the Moon card in reverse, and then we have the Two of Cups. We have the Five of Wands reversed, and we have the Ace of Wands in reverse, and we got the Magician in reverse, and the Six of Wands in reverse. Okay. Let me stop playing. So, air sign, you definitely could be dealing with a Taurus person, because I see the Hierophant, and the Hierophant is in reverse, okay? You may have Taurus in your chart as well. It's right next to the Three of Swords in reverse, so you could be dealing with the relationship situation, okay? I'm tired of the shits, I'm tired of the bullshit. I'm hearing that, okay? So you may be dealing with somebody, have been in a relationship with someone, and you decided, you know what, I'm going to go off and do my own thing, okay? You're moving past the hurt, you're moving past the pain, you're leaving that shit behind. For some of you, you may not be leaving that behind. It could be following you. Okay, it could also be causing you to have like a sense of confusion as well, because when the Hierophant is right side up, of course it talks about like constitutions, church beliefs, wisdom, all of that stuff. but it's upside down, so there's a block there. Or you could be in a rebellious stage. The person that you with could be in a rebellious stage, okay? Right? But it's upside down, so I see that for some of you, you may have a hard time tapping into your inner wisdom because of your past hurts. Your past hurts are resurfacing, okay? Okay, let's see the moon card. Okay, the moon card in reverse. So something was brought to your attention. It's like you're having a sense of realization, okay? Whatever your situation is that has caused you some hurt in the present or in the past, you're starting to understand it now. You're starting to understand that it was all for growth, okay? It was definitely all for growth. Okay. You could also be dealing with the Cancer, because the moon card represents a Cancer person as well. Oh, my husband's here. Wait for them to get in. But what's really wonderful is that this Two of Cups is at the end. Okay, so despite going through all the confusion and going through the hurt and the pain, there is a sense of equilibrium. There's a sense of balance, a sense of transformation. So you may be coming back together with a water sign person. It could be a Cancer, Pisces, or Scorpio person. Okay, you may have left a situation, a hurtful, confusing situation, toxic situation, and now you are moving on to this water sign person or this water sign energy. This can also be you becoming one with yourself and having a sense of balance within yourself as well. Okay, so if you're not meeting someone, this could just be you restoring the balance within you, being one with yourself. Okay. Let me see here. But yeah, I see that you're leaving a really tough situation and moving on to a sense of balance. Okay. Let's see. Okay, so let's go on to the second row here. I don't think I'm getting anything else from this. Okay, also for some of you, not all of you, there may have been a third party situation that you have found out about, or maybe you were involved in a third party situation and now it's out in the open. You see the truth, okay? And also, for some of you, there could have just been rumors of it, okay? But you found out that it was all a lie. And so, therefore, you're coming back together with your partner, okay? This is someone, I feel like this is someone that you already know. I just feel like it's someone that you already know, okay? Okay, so we have the Five of Wands and then we have the Ace of Wands in reverse. It's so crazy because the Five of Wands was right next to the Ace of Wands in the fire sign reading. Except the Five of Wands was right side up and then the Ace of Wands was reversed. So two fives, we got two fives, Hierophant and then the Five of Wands. Okay, so this could definitely be some inner conflict going on. Okay, air sign, you could definitely be dealing with some inner conflict. Okay, or the person that you are with or dealing with could be dealing with some inner conflict, and then therefore their fire has burnt out. Okay, their energy levels are down, it's like depleted. Okay, whatever stress or inner conflict is going on is causing them to deplete all their energy. Like, they don't have the power or energy to move forward, to overcome the situation. This very well could be you as well. I also see this as you're tired of the shits. You ain't trying to fight no more. You're not trying to deal with the BS anymore. You're going to go do your own thing. Okay? You're not going to be in alignment with this person anymore. You're going to go off and do your own thing. Okay? You're not going to put any energy towards the situation anymore. You're not going to allow this person or whoever this the situation, whatever the situation is, you're not going to allow it to drain you anymore. You're done with it. Okay? I see it that way as well. This also may be a call for some of you air signs to stand up for what you believe in and to fight for what you want. I'm not saying physically fight, but stand your ground. Okay? Do your best not to submit to other people. Okay? And how they want you to be. Okay? Because when you do that, you can no longer manifest what you want, okay? Because we have the Magician card right next to the Ace of Wands reversed, and it was reversed too, so there's a block here. So when you start living your life for other people, okay, it actually stops the magic from coming in. It stops your ability to manifest what it is that you truly want in your life, or manifest what is best for you or for your highest good. Okay, so when you start living for other people and kind of being in their shadow, it stops you from being able to manifest, and it also somewhat silences you. So because you don't, in return, you don't have a voice. You're not able to communicate and express. And the Six of Wands is right next to it, and it's in reversal. And the Six of Wands is all about victory. Okay. It's all about victory. And look at this woman. Okay, this woman has everybody catering to her. And I think it's Nefertiti, I think. Okay, but it's in reversal. Maybe you're one of these men, okay? If you're a male air sign, maybe you're tired of catering to this person. Okay, or catering to this ego. Okay, it's not going to apply to all air signs, but some of you, it will apply. You want to get out of the shadow of this person, okay, that you're dealing with. Okay. For some of you, air sign, and it sounds crazy, but there also could be someone that and maybe it could be a Gemini, because the magician is Mercury, communication. But I mean, it could be any sign, basically. Someone could definitely have an evil eye on you. Okay, someone could have done black magic on you as well, and it's causing you to not be successful. It's blocking your success. Okay. Air sign, you could be the person doing this black magic as well, okay, or magic in general. So you got to be very careful with that, okay? Got to be very, very careful with that. It's like for some of you air signs, like you do whatever it takes to get what you want, okay? And sometimes it might not be the best decision, or to have that type of vibration. Okay. Okay. So let me see if I see anything else. Also, air sign, it may be a call for you, like I said, to stand your ground and fight for what you believe in, so you can manifest what it is that you want. Okay. It's like the passion, the fire has died down, so it's important for you to tap into that. Okay, and release any self-sabotaging thoughts, okay, any type of fear, any negative self-talk, anything like that. It's time for you to snap out of that, okay? I'm also hearing for some of you, going back up to the Moon card, I hear that some of you may be stuck, feeling stuck in a cycle, feeling stuck in a relationship. some type of unit, okay? It's all an illusion, really, okay? You can free yourself at any time. All right? You can free yourself at any time. You don't have to stay stuck with someone if it's not working out. If there's not victory surrounding, you know, your relationship, you know, if there's not a sense of victory, if it's just you're in a relationship just to be comfortable, you know, it's probably not a good relationship for you. Okay? Okay. So, let's see. Okay. What else am I seeing here? But yeah, the only card that was right set up was the Two of Cups. So, you know, for this month, it's probably important that you, you know, get into the habit of giving and receiving love. You know, expressing and sharing your emotions. It's about give and take as well. It's also about a sense of balance within yourself. Balancing the masculine and the feminine energies. Okay, because once you balance the masculine and feminine energies within you, everything else is like a piece of cake. It sounds like it's crap, but it's really true. You know, once you balance that masculine and feminine energy, or balance the way you relate to other people, you know, everything else becomes pretty easy. Okay, so let's okay, we've got 3 minutes on the clock here. It's an additional message for all air signs. Additional message for all air signs. Okay. I'm using the Work Your Light Oracle. Okay. So additional message for all air signs. Libra, Gemini, and Aquarius. Libra, Gemini, Aquarius. For January 2019. Okay. Let's see. I just got this deck, so... Oh, the Age of Light. You've been trained for this for lifetimes. Okay, the Age of Light. Okay. The Age of Light. Let's see. I'm really curious to know what this is. Okay, let's see. Here we go. All right, the Age of Light. Mystics and sages throughout the ages have predicted this period in history, and you decided to incarnate in the middle of it. There is no mistake that you are supposed to be here at this time of great change. If you are ever, oh my gosh, I can't read. If you ever feel unprepared or daunted by the path that is calling you, know this. You've been training for this for lifetimes. You're way more than the days that have breathed through you in this life. You're also all of the lifetimes that came before. All of these experiences have polished your soul into the most magnificent expression that is your authentic self. Your soul has many facets. Imagine a fingerprint. Your soul is a million times more intricate than that. If you put together all of your fingerprints of all of the people you have been, you would not even get close to fathoming how much of a unique masterpiece you are. Ooh, I love that. You came in with a clear soul plan. You came in with wisdom beyond your years. This is the part of you that longs to be seen. This is the part of you that is ready to step forward, that is ready to emerge. This is not the lifetime to stay hidden, but to step forth, be seen, and rise. I love that. I love that. So going back to that Five of Wands, it's time to step forward and be seen. Okay, you see this guy down here, he looks like he's wounded. He looks like he's submitting, but no. You know, you're not meant to do that. You're not meant to submit. You're meant to rise and be seen. And that's what this Ace of Wands is all about. Okay. All right. So we'll take a look into your love life. And also, I wanted to mention that the Ace of Wands also represents like passionate, like sex, passion. There's a block here as well. Okay, so air sign, you may not be getting any. And it's probably time for you to get some, because sexual energy definitely brings about creativity and it helps raise our vibrations. As silly as it sounds, doesn't mean that you have to go out and hump on everybody, but you know, if you're in a relationship, it definitely can heal the situation. Okay, let's take a look into your love life, air signs. All air signs, let's see. Libra, Gemini, Aquarius. Let's take a look for Libra. Oh, damn, timer. I'm always going over the time. Okay, Libra. Let's surround your love life, Libra. What's surrounding your love life, Libra? Libra, what's surrounding your love life? Okay, so let's look at Gemini. Gemini, what's surrounding your love life? Gemini, what's surrounding your love life, Gemini? January 2019. Okay. Okay, then Aquarius. Aquarius, what's surrounding your love life in January? January 2019. Aquarius, what's surrounding your love life? Oh my gosh. Woo! Well, this card flipped over, so I will take that. Okay, so Aquarius, Gemini, and Libra. Oh goodness. Libra, love triangle. What? Libra, you may be trying to choose between two men, okay? If it's not actually two men, you may be trying to figure out if you should stay with the man that you're with or venture out and meet someone else, become involved with someone else, okay? So there's a sense of triangle, and I was talking about this here, you know? This could also represent Libra. You could have been dealing with someone or in a relationship with someone that was involved in a love triangle. You may have been that third person or whatever, but either way, a triangle type of energy is surrounding your romantic life, okay? A love triangle. Whatever you do, if you're thinking about dating somebody else, it's important that you break off the relationship with the person that you're with. Okay, I'm also hearing that there is also an ex that is involved. There could be an ex that is trying to make their way back into your life, knowing that you already are in a relationship, or it can be the other way around. The person that you're dealing with, maybe their ex is trying to get back into your relationship. Or get back into their life, okay? Your partner's life. Okay, so be careful with this love triangle situation, okay? And if you're thinking about venturing out and leaving a situation, leaving a relationship, just do it right. Don't double dip. Okay, so next is Gemini. Gemini, we have the Ice King. Okay. So Gemini, you very well could be dealing with a Leo, somebody that has Leo energy. Gemini, you could have Leo in your chart as well. I hear that this is a call for you to be very decisive, to be very clear on what it is that you want in your relationship. If you are involved in a relationship currently, and you're going through some difficult times, it's going to be a call for you to be very clear on what the imbalances are so you can bring about a sense of stability. Be very clear. Also, this could mean that, Gemini, you may come off very cold at times, okay? And not as warm and fuzzy, okay? Because you have this Ace of Wands reversed. The fire is dead in here, okay? So it's really important to be very aware of this and make any adjustments that you need to, with either within yourself or within your relationship, or you know, whatever your surroundings. Okay, what else am I seeing here? Oh, and you know, Gemini, you may meet an Ice King, okay, if you're single. This could be a good or bad thing, you know, because the Ice King could definitely be a clear, decisive, maybe even a businessman, but also they can be a cold-hearted asshole. Or this could, like I said, could be you being a cold-hearted, you know what. All right, last card, Aquarius. So friendship. Wah, wah. It sounds kind of boring, right? But it's not. So, Aquarius, let's see. You may be trying to grow a friendship into a romantic relationship. Okay? For some of you, you could be trying to do that. But you may have been friend-zoned. But it does not mean that you need to give up on love or to have a bad perspective on love. Also, in order to have a really great relationship, it's important to be friends first. It's important to get to know the person that you're wanting to be with as well. Let me see here. Also, it's going to call for you to be a bit more supportive. Yeah, you may be in a relationship with someone and you feel like, okay, if I buy this, if I buy, you know, a gift for my girl or my boyfriend, it's going to solve everything or whatever. But it's going to call for you to maybe be a little bit more supportive versus just purchasing things and saying, okay, forgive and forget. So it's going to really call for you to really be a true friend to the person that you are with. Okay, it doesn't mean that the relationship decreases in value. It's just that friendship is a really strong bond. Okay, let's see here. I think that's pretty much it. Oh yes, also you may for some of you Aquarius, you may be in a relationship and your friends are getting away in the way of your relationship, or the person that you are with, their friends are getting involved in the relationship. So there's definitely a need to bring back balance and not allow your friends to really dictate or influence your relationship, because at the end of the day, it's only you two that is in this relationship. I don't see anybody else around here. Okay, I don't see anybody else. Okay, so I don't think there's anything else, air sign. So that's going to conclude the reading for January 2019 for all air signs. If you would like to book a reading with me, feel free to do so. My email is in the description box below. And I hope you guys have a wonderful rest of the month. And I'll be back in February. God bless.